This story is called Beware of Boys by Tony Blundell, and it was published in 1991. To the wolf, without whom. Once upon a time, not so very long ago, nor so very far away, a small boy took a shortcut through the forest and was captured by a hungry wolf. "Silly boy," said the wolf, and carried him back to his cave. "What are you going to do with me?" asked the boy. The wolf licked his lips. "Why, eat you, of course," he replied. "Raw?" said the boy. The wolf roared. "No," said the boy. "I mean, aren't you even going to cook me first?" The wolf thought about it. "Go on then," he said. "What do you suggest?"
"I do just happen to know a very good recipe for boy soup," said the boy.
The wolf, who was both hungry and greedy, could hardly contain himself. He dribbled, "Tell me what I need." So the boy told him. "Recipe for boy soup. Ingredients to serve one greedy wolf. One boy, medium size, one large iron pot, one ton of potatoes, one oodle of onions, one wooden tub of turnips, one cartload of carrots, one packet of fruit chews, one well full of water, one barrel of bricks, one trowel. Method? Number one, first, catch the boy. Two, wash him thoroughly, especially behind the ears. Three, place him firmly in the iron pot. Four, add water, potatoes, onions, turnips, carrots, and fruit chews to taste. Five, sit on the barrel of bricks and stir with the trowel until Thursday." Off the wolf ran to gather the ingredients. He raced here and there, to and fro, up and down, round and round, over and under, this way and that. When the wolf returned, the boy checked through everything.
"Aw, silly wolf," he said, "you've forgotten the salt."
The wolf's face fell. "But you didn't say salt," he spluttered. "Well, not to worry," said the boy. "I've just remembered an even more delicious dish, which, as it happens, needs no salt." The wolf's stomach started to rumble rather badly. "Great stuff," he said. Tell me.
"It's called boy pie,"
said the boy, popping a fruit chew into his mouth, "and it's three times as good as boy soup." "Yum," said the wolf. "But you will need just a few things," said the boy. "Recipe for boy pie ingredients to serve one greedy and bad-tempered wolf, one boy, not too skinny, one large pie dish, three foothills of plain flour, one moo cow of milk, one large lump of lard, six sacks of cement, one load of leeks, one bird bath of beans, one packing case of parsnips, one shovel, one cowboy hat, one yellow yo-yo. Method. One, toss the flour, milk, and lard with a shovel until done. Two, arrange the boy comfortably in the pie dish. Three, fill his pockets with vegetables and cover with pastry. Four, place the yo-yo in the hat and sit on it. Five, inspect the pie hourly, then daily, until golden brown." Off scampered the wolf. He scurried here and there, to and fro, up and down, round and round, over and under, this way and that. When the wolf came struggling back, huffing and puffing, the boy examined the goods.
"Oh, wolf," he said, "silly wolf, you've forgotten the salt."
The wolf went weak at the knees. "But you said this one needed no salt," he groaned. "Well, it does," said the boy, "but never mind. I've just remembered the most fantastically scrumptious dish that ever was, and it definitely doesn't need salt." The wolf had almost decided on raw boy again. He pricked up his ears, though. "Go on," he growled. "Tell me."
"It's called boy cake," said the boy, "and it's 10 times better than boy pie."
"And I suppose," the wolf sighed hopelessly, "that I'll need just a few things." "Right," said the boy. "Recipe for boy cake. Ingredients to serve one ravenously hungry and exhausted wolf. One boy, as fat as you like, one bathtub, one big blob of butter, one bin full of brown sugar, 5 fire buckets of flour, one handbag of hen's eggs, one brick outhouse, one wheelbarrow of walnuts, one shopping bag of currants, one bunch of bananas, one red bicycle, 2 barn doors, one seashore of sand, one bunch of daffodils. Method. Number one, place the boy in a warm room and allow him to watch television. Number two, mix the butter, flour, brown sugar, and hen's eggs in the bathtub. Three, blend in the barn doors, bananas, currants, and walnuts. Four, carefully add the bicycle, sand, and daffodils. Five, if it rains, stand in the outhouse. The wolf crawled off once more. He stumbled here and there, to and fro, up and down, round and round, over and under, this way and that. It was some time before the wolf returned, staggering under an enormous mountain of ingredients. The boy took a long, long look.
"Oh, silly, silly wolf," he said, shaking his head sadly. "You've forgotten the salt."
There was a tremendous crash as the wolf collapsed. Down went the wolf. Down came the barn doors. Down came the bicycle. Down came the outhouse. Down came the wheelbarrow, the walnuts, and the currants. Down came the fire buckets, the butter, and the bin. Down came the bananas, the hen's eggs, and the sand. Luckily, the boy managed to catch the daffodils.
The wolf lay stunned. Napping in the afternoon, wolf tut tut, said the boy as he mixed together the cement, water, and sand. You really should take a little more exercise, he said, as he placed brick upon brick and built a wall right across the mouth of the wolf's cave. Silly old wolf, he thought, as he rode the red bicycle back through the forest. When he was home, his mother was waiting for him. Mother, mother, he cried, I took a shortcut through the forest and was captured by a hungry wolf, and he gave me this candies and this hat and a new bike, and he sent you these flowers. He sounds nice, said his mother. Now sit down and eat up your supper while it's hot. Which is more than the wolf did that night. And that is, beware of boys.